MES founders keen moves, charity commissioner opposing Nusli Wadia's move to take control of society. New scheme proposed by Wadia is a move to usurp properties of the society. Existing constitution in perfect order as required under various status governing trust. Existing scheme under which the society operates since the past 86 year is well in place and a copy of which out to be available with the charity commissioner.
First of all, I am an academician, and when I read the news first last year about the case of Wadia's against the Modern Education Society, it was really painful for me. Then when I understood the things from the news, it was clear to me that the Wadias, they want to change the constitution, and the constitution which is in force now, that would be completely changed, and it will be controlled basically by the Wadia family. Now this society, Modern Education Society, has been running for 86 years now, since 1932 it was established. Nothing has gone wrong. In fact, the society has progressed. Several institutions have been founded. They have been running well. Nauruzji Wadia College has recently got A+ grade. Bombay also, Mumbai, there are two institutions. In Pune, there are five institutions. They are all running well. There is no problem, running smoothly. Academic high standards have been maintained by the staff. And in the constitution, you see the constitution of Modern Education Society, the teachers only can become life members. So this is very unique. And I feel when it has been running 86 years successfully, why not give it a fair chance of running it further? Because the present constitution is democratic. If you see the current constitution, there is a board of life members, there is a finance committee, there is a senate, there is a general body. So looking at this constitution and the provisions, I think it is just fair to leave it like that. Of course, constitution can always be modified. Such amendments have been made in the constitution earlier. So let it run. And as an academician, I have interacted with the physics, particularly physics department, because I was professor of physics in the university. And then I found that good amount of research is being done there. The staff is being encouraged. I mean, what else you require? So basically, this is the reason why I felt, as a grandson of Principal Zhu, but more as an academician in the university. Well, it is not a personal opposition. It's opposition to the scheme that they have proposed, that the person from Wadia family and that will be the main trustee, then the his two sons will be another two trustees, and they can appoint another trustees, not necessarily teachers. So it will be totally controlled, and entire business will be dealt with by this board of trustees. So even there is a provision of selling some acquired assets. All the authority will rest with the trustees. So this is not proper, because it is authoritarian outlook, while the previous constitution is completely democratic. And you will see what I have noticed with the Modern Education Society, that there is no political influence. You know, you can find some societies where there is a political influence. Certain group or certain party people, they are controlling the society. This can be seen. But Wadia and the modern Ajivin society are exception. And basically, because teachers only can become life members. So, this is very unique and I would like to highlight that aspect. So, that's why this whole system is democratic. So, why destroy this democratic system?
Next question. How is Wadia new proposed scheme? If charity commissioner approves it, what will be the fallout?
You mean the scheme proposed by Wadia's?
Yes.
Well, it's for everybody to imagine what will happen if there is an authoritarian outlook. A certain family deciding everything about the society. So, I think it's not fair. You see all the universities, the University Act, it provides many democratic ways. There are elections, although the number of elections have been reduced, but still there are elections and teachers are elected. They are also elected from other bodies, but mainly it is controlled by teachers. You can see that University Act approved by Maharashtra. Yeah. So, I think the democratic system has to be preserved in large institutions and such societies. Well, see, this is what I don't understand, because earlier in the last few years when the society has constructed so many buildings, has acquired some land, so when you try to go and seek the permission of the charity commissioner, the joint charity commissioner, then such permissions have been given, quoting certain rule, certain para in the constitution. So, why the constitution is not there now with the joint charity commissioner? I don't know.
Last question. How much properties does MES have and what would be the approximate value of such properties?
Well, I don't know whether I'll be able to guess the value, but approximately I know. The original land that was acquired by the then founding fathers, it was about 18 acres of land, and most of the present institutions are on these 18 acres of land. Then of course the society has the DG Ruparel College in Mumbai and New Law College also in Mumbai. There also they have lands and property and buildings and everything. And also I came to know recently that near Wagholi also the society has purchased some land. So that much is the property, it is huge.